guys, welcome to Cochin.
Thanks, Shruti.
Okay, so for the last 3 days, you know, like my phone has been ringing off the hook.
Really?
So I was damn excited. So Friday, like I checked my phone and the first time in my life, I had like 10 missed calls. Like, damn, I'm so popular kind of thing. So I'm like, okay, let me try a return. And all unknown numbers or like people who I hardly speak to kind of thing. So I called back the first person who called me. And they're like, hi, Shruti, long time. I said, yeah, long time, how are you? And I was excited, right?
You didn't know who it was?
No, I know who it was. It was very evident that they really didn't want to talk to me that much. So, dear comrade, Vijay and Rashmika are coming to coach. I said, yeah, we would like to meet them. I said, oh, yes, sure, no problem. And I thought, okay, one call, second call, third call, fourth call. Damn, guys, I'm not popular. But welcome to Cochin. Welcome to Kerala. You have like a huge, huge fan base here. How exciting is it?
It was super fun. Already yesterday, we came to do the Dear Comrade Music Festival and we performed at the Gokul Convention. It was amazing. The crowd, and they love the music so much. They were all standing in front, even when we weren't performing, when just the singers were singing, they were all standing, clapping, cheering for the singers. But it was a really fun show anyways, but these guys were just something. Right.
But also there's something like so beautiful about the music that it's like within in our movie, like Madhupole and the canteen song. It was so exciting. Right. So I was not aware that, you know, there was a song, the canteen song was something that was there. So when I saw it was so peppy and, you know, it was really nice. The excitement is ridiculous.
Okay.
And of course, like, because it's Dear Comrade, right from when you guys announced the movie, like that was very long back.
Yeah.
So before I knew I was even part of the movie, I think it had created like waves in...
Because of the word
Because of Comrade in it.
Okay.
So, and of course, like post Arjun Reddy, different market altogether, and Geeta Govindam and everything, you know. So everyone in Cochin has been damn excited by this whole thing. And so how was your Malayalam? That's what everyone wants to know. How are both your Malayalams? And when are you going to work in an only Malayalam movie?
Sugamano.
My Malayalam is Sugamano.
Yeah.
And in the Kyondu Vishesham.
Yeah, not bad, is it?
And Enda Malayali Galai.
That was there in the video.
Yeah, these are all bits.
And you?
And I had something on my hand yesterday, but it washed off.
Yeah, I thought of writing something on my hand and going and
it is,
it.
Didn't say anything.
Yeah.
What you said?
No, I know something like Valare Sandosham Unde.
This is my line.
I practice this line as well.
എനിക്ക്
ഏറ്റവും സന്തോഷം തരുന്ന ഒരു നിമിഷമാണ് ഇത്. ബിക്കോസ് ദിസ് ഇസ് എക്സാക്ട്ലി ഹൗ ഐ വാസ് ഓൺ ദ സെറ്റ്സ് ഓഫ് ഡിയർ കോമ്രേഡ്. ബട്ട് ഐ ഡോണ്ട് തിങ്ക് ഐ ഹവ് ടോൾഡ് യു ദിസ് ഓൺ ദ സെറ്റ്സ്. ബട്ട് താങ്ക് യു സോ മച്ച് ഗൈസ്. രശ്മികയും ഞാനും കൂടി വി ഹാഡ് വൺ സീൻ വെയർ ഇൻ ദ ബെഡ്റൂം വെയർ യു വർ ഗെറ്റിംഗ് ഡൗൺ ദ സൂട്ട് കേസ്. സോ ഇൻ ദാറ്റ് സീൻ ഐ തിങ്ക് ദാറ്റ് we took some, I don't know how many shots, and our lady was just so patient and was just sitting there. Everyone actually, Sujit and Bharat and everyone, they were just so patient and they're like, no, it's okay, don't worry. I'm like, my good Lord, I just hope I get through this scene. But now watching all of you try, and both of you try and speak in Malayalam. It's okay.
I actually enjoy watching the reaction for the trailer so much. Yesterday night, the entire time, I'm just like watching the reactions. And it was like,
why don't you send me some if there are any?
There's so many. You just type Dear Comrade trailer reaction, you get so many. So
and
we'll make one with you,
Bhavadi. Like when the teaser released on set, I think we were shooting something. You were sitting and watching all the reactions for the teasers, and I had half the mind to take a video of your reaction to the reaction, because it is so exciting, you know, to see Of course, a lot of love and effort has gone into this movie. So when you see like a bunch of people reacting so beautifully, like whatever you guys or whatever we expected when the thing was out, when the reaction is times 10 or times 100 or whatever, you know, it's very heartening, I'm assuming.
What was your reaction to the song then?
Song was beautiful. Yes, it is.
Yeah.
Which song?
Madhubole.
Okay.
Madhubole is on loop on everyone's phone. Or like any cab I got into at that time, he or she used to play Madhubole. And everyone was dancing to Madhubole. And when the monsoons arrived, it was in people's monsoon playlist and, you know, things like that. It's genuinely such a like effortlessly beautiful song.
There's something about it.
There's something about it. You can't really pinpoint it. Yeah. It's everything.
Yeah.
You know.
Let me interview you. Okay. of course, the cliche question: your experience working with the dear comrade team, rather than each one of us.
So initially, I was very very. Apprehensive and nervous, if I can use those words. Nervous, I don't know, but nervous because Telugu, and I'm just so Bharat had sent me the list of dialogues and all that, and I couldn't make head or tail of it. And the first scene we did was a slightly comic scene, and I was just telling someone that when I was giving the dialogues, suddenly Kannada that I didn't know came out. And yenaitu, I had to say yenaitu, and then like yenaitu.
That is Kannada.
Yeah. And so then we finished the scene and everything, and Tulsi Garu was on set, and she's like, Amma, you have to say
yenaitu.
I'm like, oh, okay, so next time. Yenaitu. And then the AD pulls me away, and he's like, very seriously, he's not making fun of me, nothing. He's like, madam, it's a Telugu movie. I'm like, sorry. So this is the first day
of shoot
for me, but every day had something like this. But it was absolute. Everyone made me feel so comfortable, and you know, it was. I loved it as good as
did
working at home.
Did you miss us in your other set?
Yeah.
Did you miss us in your other set? Come on.
Yes, not, of course. No, you cute. Did. Not on like. Set, I'll be very honest, set is different altogether, but I came out of Dear Comrade and I'm like, hey, that was a fun set to be on.
See?
So.
See?
I'm sure, I didn't even need to ask that question.
He was not.
No, but then I just
actively
like.
Participant in your bonding, but but I remember Bharat bringing me your first audition video, like, so Shruti plays an important character called Jaya, and we needed someone who's, of course, older to Lily, because she's Lily's older sister, older cousin. And I shouldn't reveal more of the story, but Bobby kind of, she's like the girl who the entire neighborhood kind of crushes on type. And we needed someone super expressive and this and that. And we had one actress, Telugu actress in mind. But then Bharat was like, I don't know where he saw you. But
he saw one.
Sunday Holiday.
It was a movie that I did.
Okay.
It actually released 2 years back today.
Okay.
So he saw a song in that.
Happy anniversary.
So he saw something somewhere, and I was like, there is this one girl, I'm calling her to Hyderabad and stuff. And I was like, okay. And then he showed me a video of you on his phone of her doing a little Bharatnatyam. And then we all saw that, and I was like, this is it. This is her. This is Jaya. And then came on set and then did whatever. And we all used to trip on her expression with her eyes and stuff. And then in the movie, Jaya has come out absolutely beautiful.
Okay, thanks, guys.
Because I've seen the film.
Interview over.
Yeah. Let's end it on a high. Let's retire.
I was totally not expecting that, but thank you. Okay, now. On set, I had given you a list of movies to watch. How many of those Malayalam movies have you watched?
Zero. One. Bad. One, actually. One.
Which one?
It was this Fahad's film that you watched, which I can tell you the story. The title is really complicated.
Tondi Modalam.
It's about
him wanting to go somewhere abroad and...
No, it's about, you know, he's constantly taking this ship to see this girl who's on it and... Wait, I'll tell you, wait. Now I forgot the rest of the film. I'm remembering this one sequence.
But did you watch part. Anything? I have an entire Kerala watching you.
I watched one of Sir's very recent film. He's Good trying nice. To...
That's something we spoke about a lot. But now it's on. It's online also, so I should watch. Kumbhalangi Nights. We were speaking of yeah, it yeah, while yeah. We were shooting. Since then, I've heard so much about it. Yeah, so many people talking about yeah. it. Yeah, because it's come on Prime, even more people have seen it. And yeah. I should watch. Yeah. Even this, the boy in it is also so charming, man. Shane Nigam.
Yeah.
Like, I saw his other trailer called Ishq as well.
Ishq is also on Amazon Prime actually.
Now? Okay. But yeah, I've had people watch it and say it's extremely disturbing. Yeah.
So guys, now your job is cut out.
Kumbhalangi Night shall be watched in the next 10 days.
Ellarum kettalo? Okay. So one thing that people have asked me, but I don't think I've been very equipped to give the answer is, why Dear Comrade? Like, comrade as a word, I don't think everyone understands. Does it have a strong link to politics or, you know, something like that? Is what everyone thinks.
Yeah. I think as soon as you hear the word comrade, because of how we've grown up and how it's been attached to the communist parties, we immediately think it's like a political film. But here we take the basic meaning of a word comrade, which is a comrade is someone who's there with you, who's a support system while you want to achieve your goals, who's always there by your side supporting you through your highs and lows and good times and bad. So the word comrade came from that. And it also has this character, the character I play called Bobby, has certain communist influence because his grandfather in the film, played by Charu Hassan sir, plays a character called Comrade Suryam, who was a communist leader. So this guy has got it from there, and they are part of this student union. It has nothing to do with politics, but he has this philosophy of fighting for your rights, fighting for what you love, fighting for this thing. That things come from his grandfather. So there's this whole sub-layer of the spirit of standing up for yourself and fighting for what you love, that he's also trying to tell the other characters in the film. And I guess that's why comrade, the word comrade came from. And when you watch the film, you'll understand how it is, how the word is there in almost every scene.
Oru comrade poradumbol avana poratam kondu മനസമാധാനവും സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യവും ഉണ്ടാവണം. നിന്നെ കാണുമ്പോൾ അങ്ങനെ തോന്നുന്നില്ല.
ഹലോ ക്യൂട്ട്സ്,
ഹായ്.
സോ
ഡു യു മിസ് ദ സ്നാപ്പ് ഫിൽട്ടേഴ്സ് വിത്ത് മീ?
യാ, ദാറ്റ് ഐ ഡു.
ദീസ് ടു യൂസ് ടു ഡു സംതിങ് ഓൺ സെറ്റ്.
Oh yeah.
Something they used to be doing, which is I think we should get Shruti to do it.
Yeah, she's a teacher.
A little later.
What is it, Shruti? Let's see it. Let's see it once. Before yeah, the
you told me. I
think you should. Everyone knows it.
He doesn't know it.
See,
you know that
he
knows.
He shifted. He came this side to see. He's like, I want to witness this. Come on, Shruti. Let's see you do it, and then let's see Lily.
Teach me now. You said it.
Every day on set, I used to hear this one, so I might as well. It's been a while, so let's hear the Malayalam version of
we'll
it.
Okay, we'll do this.
Dude, it's not a language. It's
let's make it a little Malayali.
Trolls.
Now you do
oh,
it.
Oh no, it's too fast for me to cope up.
From where did you pick that up? You created
no
it.
No more questions to me. Now I will.
No, curious, Ray.
So
let's move on.
So, Rashmika, the one thing that I noticed while working with you on Lily is not a very easy character to pull off. Actually, Lily is not an easy character to pull off. She's got a lot of layers and, you know, a lot of things that she goes through and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. That level of dedication can obviously come out only from an incredible level of passion that you probably, that you most certainly, both of you for that matter, have for your profession. So, I don't know if this is a very cliche question, but this is something that I've always wanted to ask you. Was movies always something that you wanted to do? I know you've been asked it many number of times.
No, yeah. Like, it was never in my plans, ever. But when I did start off, it felt like I needed to do justice to what I started. And I don't like incomplete work. Like, I need to complete what I'm, got my mind set to. And also, talking about Lily, you remember me coming and asking you, how do you think I should play this character? How do you think, you know, I should take forward of this character? Should she be extremely emotional? I don't know how to play it. This was the initial days, if you remember. And you told me, just be in it. Just don't try to work on it. Just be in it and just feel it. And I think somewhere, I don't know if I took the advice or I don't know how it went forward. But initially, like, after you said that, after we shot for a long period of time, I realized that I was in it. And that's when I was sitting and thinking that this is what you meant. Because till then, I didn't know what you exactly meant. I didn't know how to be in a character. But then once I was like, okay, now this is what you meant.
This was 2 years. Is that what you said?
From when I heard the script to launching the film to developing it, pre-production, shooting, and all, I think it's been 2.5-3 years.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Because I heard it while I was doing Arjun Reddy, and I don't know when I did Arjun Reddy. But
you don't know when.
What year?
It's
did
been
I?
2 years.
2 years, huh? So I heard it while I was doing Arjun Reddy. So I think it's been a 2 year journey. I remember Bharat coming to my Arjun Reddy set in the first part of the Arjun Reddy shoot, because I had a bearded look then, and I remember I was shooting this scene where I'm running behind the maid in the house. So I was running behind, Bharat was sitting on a chair, I was running behind the maid doing the shot, then coming back sitting with him, and we're like, yeah, so what are we, what's happening, like, tell me the line. And I remember him telling me about Lily's character and this and that, and then again going running behind the maid and then coming, and we like, okay, so she's this and we're doing this. So I remember this conversation happening, and then
I'd like to go back and see that maid scene now.
And then the scripts, like, matured over time. It's taken a lot of layers were added, layers were removed, it was developed. But since the first time we heard it, Bharat knew the world of Dear Comrade. He knew the world where it will be set in. He knew Kakinada. He knew the colors. He knew how this character was and how this character was.
Yeah, but that's actually very, very true, because when he was narrating, like, in the story to me, it was so vivid, know, he was vividly telling me, you know, every scene, and also his visual of Jaya, right? He's like, in the first half, I'd want you to wear a round bindi, second half onwards, you can wear. I've never worked with a director who has spoken to me about my portrait, about my bindi. So that was one of the things which, you know, drew me to just the extent to which he knew his characters and things like that. Speaking of Arjun Reddy, it's become a sensation. But was it overnight, or?
That's like the world's reaction to you is overnight. But for me, it was like a that was also another 1.5-2 year journey from listening to the script, then getting the look for the film, and then shooting it. We shot that also over like 8-9 months, and then there was 6 months of pre-production. But even the teaser, every poster in its own small way was a rage, because fewer people knew me. But other than the fewer people, a whole bunch would go crazy about it. When the teaser released, a whole bunch went mad over it. When the trailer released, it grew wider. When the film released, it blew.
When the film released, it was like over all languages that it became. I mean, not languages, over all regions,
regions
it became.
That it became. And then see, now they made it into Kabir Singh, and now it's like a nationwide blow up that's happened, and that's bringing conversation back to what we did today.
Is it?
Yeah, these were all films that are very personal. Like for me in my career, like Pelli Chupulu was a really personal film, and it was a film where at the editing table we felt we didn't know even if it will even get a release. Pelli Chupulu. We are like, our objective then was, our producers put 70 odd lakhs, 1 crore, if they make that enough, man. And we were like, we'll be happy with the film, because we showed the film to a whole bunch of people who didn't like it. They're like, we don't care if they like it or not. We know it's a good film because we like the music of the film. We like the scenes in it. We like the performance. We're like, we like it. That's it. That this is our meter. We like it. If the world gets it or not, let's see. It released and it was huge then. Arjun Reddy was another film which we were like, because it was so different from what's been done, we half thought maybe no one will get this film, man. Like, there is a chance no one will get it. It was also a film that not many people believed in. But then we were like, dude, but this is what we want to do. And me and Sandeep at one point were like, if it doesn't work tomorrow, we might go mad. Because you believe in this film so much.
Yeah.
And if the world rejects it, then you're like, maybe I don't know. Maybe what me and you like is one such a niche. How do we make cinema which is for an audience? I did a film called Taxi Wala also, which was really personal because we made it how we wanted. Now, Dear Comrade is another film which is so personal because we completely made these four films according to our whim, our wish, our taste. Like, the clothes are exactly what we want to wear. The music is exactly how we want it. The dialogue is exactly what we want. We don't do anything for the market or for the audience or to play to this gallery or to play to that gallery or to please the producer or to please the hero or to please the heroine. Everyone behaves as we want everyone. So these films are really personal and you're proud of them irrespective of how huge it becomes or how badly it fares or whatever. It doesn't matter. All these three films were really personal and they all did superiorly well. This is another film in that space.
We shot bits of this movie in Kerala as well. Right?
Yes.
In Adirambali. I was not part of that schedule. But I happened to go to Adirambali 2 weeks later.
Okay.
And I stayed at this resort. They took us on a trek. So Francis and I and the guide. And this guy just looks at me like, oh, Malayalam industry, Malayalam artist. not like, oh, Malayalam. Vijay Devarakonda was here. So, who are you? So I'm like, yeah, oh, really? Okay. Vijay and Rashmika, they were all shooting here for Telugu project. CIA remake. So I said, okay. And finally he said, you know them? I said, no.
When he sees the film, he's going to be like, what?
No. And recently, I'd shared the
song.
Trailer and the trailer.
No. Okay. I think I shared Madhupole.
Okay.
I don't remember what. Something I shared. So he's messaging me on Instagram. So he's like, why? Oh, you know about this movie. Something. Then after that, the trailer he saw. And then he's like, oh, you are in the movie.
You're in CIA remake.
So that was like what really funny incident that happened. So where else, I think, do you guys shoot in Ooty also?
No, we shot in Vagamon.
Vagamon.
Oh, you shot in Vagamon. Oh, nice.
We shot in Vagamon and then we shot in and around Adrapelli.
And how was Ladakh?
Oh, Ladakh was superb. You know,
was this the first time you were shooting there?
It was the first time I was shooting there. The place is beautiful. It was minus, it was super cold. We were working extraordinary hours because we would start in the, we would start at 6 a.m. from the hotel and we would be shooting till 11, 12. We would be driving and shooting. But because the geography, because the nature is so beautiful, work doesn't seem that hard. Because I'm acting and I just see this beauty everywhere, man. It was absolutely stunning. And the locals were so helpful, be it here or be it in Ladakh. Because we went with a smaller crew, we needed much more help from the locals. And they were so extremely helpful. And we would always, you want to clean up when you see a place so beautiful. I hate it when it's littered. But the locals also would help us clear up, and they're all very particular about their place being clean, which is very nice. Yeah, which is very nice. And they were also, they would go out of their way, man, to help us. Like our bikes would get stuck and they would be pushing our bikes. We were flying drones, and Ladakh is a military area. And then the military guys came because we didn't have permission to fly drones. And usually, apparently,
we've done some illegal things.
So we saw some military things coming and parking up, and immediately the locals, the drivers were parked. No, immediately they ran there. They knew something was up. So they went, they managed, and then they quickly told us, hide the walkie-talkies, do this and all. Then we did this, then the cop came, and then we explained the shoot and stuff. He was like, normally we shoot down drones when they're flying. Apparently they shoot. He took our drone and he said, I don't want you to shoot. Come and collect it tomorrow when we were leaving from that area. So my manager, apparently they took them to the thing, and they saw some 45-50 drones, some shot, some confiscated, some broken. There's a whole collection of drones that they don't give back. But ours, they were really nice, and we explained to them what we were trying to do and what we were doing, and they were like, okay, but some areas don't shoot with drones. But but it was and the visuals have come out really beautifully.
Whatever little
so
I saw.
Yeah.
I know you're jealous.
I'm so jealous.
So after that, we had a schedule in Kakinada where every day I heard Rashmika was talking to Sujit, complaining as to why it was very important that you guys took her as well too.
Yeah. No, we invited you.
Huh?
Didn't we say?
No, really
she was
not.
Like, but no, we did. She said, I don't have shoot, what will I come and do?
No. Mm. Let me get that right. Yes. No. You didn't say no. Bharat thought of calling me in because they thought of keeping few visuals.
Yeah, that we decided not to do, but we still said you can still come and like assist on
site. How will they say? You can come if you want.
Yeah, because so when we
it?
Know
how,
that
how do you
she,
take it? How
just
do you
go, it's Ladakh.
I can't just go like that, no? Like if they're like, say, you come. Someone has to sit me down and be like, you come. Good if you come. Then I'll go. Otherwise, I'll only come, okay? Please take me and all of that. How can I just...
The thing is, immediately after coming back from Ladakh, we knew we were dealing with some complicated scenes and we wanted to figure some stuff out. So, we also thought it'll be nice if she's there so that we can figure out all the emotions and the drama, and then she can get... Because if you're in Hyderabad, she'll go to gym twice a day. And we are scared she'll become one beast by the time...
But
at one point in the film, she was more muscular than me also.
Yeah.
Can you please lose?
I have broad shoulders. I can't help it. This comes with papa, mama.
Do you think this is coming out of a place of pure jealousy, Rashmika?
It is. I absolutely agree. She was lifting more. She was...
There Vijay is damn it.
No, I'm lifting those pink and green dumbbells, and she's, for women, we keep for aerobics and all little colorful dumbbells, which are 2.5-3 kgs. I hadn't gone to the gym for 4-5 months because of all these schedules. Meanwhile, she went twice a day and she goes to 4 different gyms in the city. And I came, and then she's like, what do you call that move? Deadlifting. She's deadlifting like 60 kgs, 70 kgs, and then I'm like, please don't come to the gym at the same time as me. Can you go in the morning or go in the night?
I keep telling him go to the gym.
I think he's like, I'm too busy. Happy. This is probably the first time we are seeing Vijay in a place that is very insecure and jealous.
I have ensured that she stops lifting, right? Because she was, we were calling her Dangal. They're like, you look like that, you know, these, I'm losing vocabulary, dude.
Yeah,
these wrestlers. Like in Dangal, those two girls trained for...
Clearly, broken him. Yeah. He's lost, words.
I think even my team agrees. My entire team was like, Rashmika, okay, you're looking like strong. We need you to look like Lily. Your name is Lily. It's not Pehlwan Lily.
What you do in the movie?
Yeah.
So, cricketer can look little...
like a wrestler.
Yeah.
Let's wind it up with Shruti singing.
You start.
You start. Because you... Or you start with...
We stop. No, you start.
Can we cut that part and have it as a background track of the entire interview? Just in the background like...
I'll give another background track for this.
Okay. We'll all sing Madhupole for our Kerala comrades. Oh, yes. Malayali comrades and...
I know two words.
I'll give the talam.
We also know only two words, so it's okay.
Okay, you
five,
should start.
5, 6, 7, 8.
I told you have to start.
She's being such a bad Malayali, I feel. She hasn't watched the Malayalam trailer. She's not singing the Malayalam song of Madhupole.
See, Malayali audience knows very well I cannot sing.
What, you used to always sing on set?
Yeah. On set, I have all the guts to sing because I don't really think anyone is listening.
He said before this interview, think that this is set. Yeah. This is not an interview.
You also said the same thing, no?
Yeah, we're chilling and talking, but... Yeah.
Okay, you can sing, other songs also. The Aga Sa Nerolam.
Who?
Any song you sing.
Aga?
Aga Sa Nerolam. What is that? Aga Sa Vidi Kattu. That is Tamil, la. Neerolam tararara na sontan.
No, I don't know that song. I'll,
you know? You
know Madhupole.
You were listening to it on loop, my friend.
Yeah.
Yeah, see, so that's the thing with me and songs, you know. So I listen.
Excuses.
I will hear it. I will listen to it.
Excuses.
You shut up, not. Let's not change the subject. Okay, fine. Sing. Listen, Vijay, I can't sing.
Okay, I'll sing with you.
5, 4.
No. Not 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, Ray.
1, 2, 3, go.
Madhupole Preeta Marae Manasage Araga Tarara Inayaya Shalabam Pole Niyum Nyanum.
Sorry, I'm very bad at singing. So let's hope that the movie is absolutely loved by everyone, like every other movie of yours.
It was lovely seeing you again, Shruti, and
lovely meeting you guys too.
And I hope you enjoy the Malayalam. Which version are you watching first?
I'll watch
you'll come and watch it with us.
Done.
Yeah.
I think you should watch Malayalam version first. What you'll watch it with us. You give us from Kochi, you tell us what's happening here. Like
that,
first morning.
Whatever you want, I will do.
So watch Malayalam version and then call and say, dude, this is what's happening
or
here.
Or send us the video of the audience.
Mm-hmm. Audience response. The reaction I'll send you.
Yeah. And how you're reacting to
that. And then we can watch Telugu and whichever else language you want. Yeah. So it's your responsibility to update us on the Malayalam version.
Done. Okay. That'll be given.
Yes. Super.
So.
Sure.